Hello, I'm Dr. Ziad Kazi. I'm a medical toxicologist working with the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. Radiation can affect the body in a number of ways. How the body will be affected depends on the amount of radiation absorbed by the body, known as the dose, the type of radiation, how long the person is exposed, and which part of the body is exposed. In a radiation emergency, one of the possible health effects of radiation exposure is cutaneous radiation injury, or CRI. Let's learn more about what CRI is, how it can happen, what it may look like, and what to do if you experience symptoms of CRI after a radiation emergency.
Cutaneous radiation injury, CRI, happens when exposure to a large, concentrated dose of radiation causes injury to the skin. A doctor will suspect the presence of a CRI when a skin burn develops on a person who was not exposed to a source of heat, electrical current, or chemicals. People may experience a CRI if they are exposed to certain types of radioactive materials that give off beta particles, penetrating gamma radiation, or low-energy X-rays. People who experience acute radiation syndrome, ARS, may experience signs of CRI, but not everyone who develops CRI will have ARS. Symptoms of CRI can appear from a few hours to several days after exposure. The early signs and symptoms of CRI include itchiness, tingling, skin redness or erythema, swelling or edema caused by a buildup of fluid. Over time, other symptoms may develop depending on the site of the injury and the level of radiation dose to which the skin was exposed. After a radiation emergency, if you experience these symptoms, seek medical attention as soon as emergency officials say it is safe to do so. If you cannot get medical attention quickly, gently rinse the area with water. Keep the area clean, dry, and covered until a doctor can provide additional treatment.
Remember, if you experience symptoms of CRI after a radiation emergency, seek medical attention as soon as emergency officials say it is safe to do so. To learn more about cutaneous radiation injuries, please visit our website.